Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Sipogazi William and today I'm going to be doing a wig review for you guys, but also just showing how I install the wig and just how I like basically work with the wig from the box and onto my head, so it looks like this, all laid and stuff. So if you just want to hear more about this hair, which I did receive from fsisterwig.com, and it's been a pleasure working with them, then carry on watching. So like I mentioned, the hair is from fsisterwig.com, also just the company is fsister. I had the opportunity to pick any wig that I wanted from their website and I really wanted to do something different from like the usual body wave or straight Brazilian virgin hair. So I went for this kinky straight virgin hair, which is amazing. Anyway, we'll get into all of that. So the style that I went with is the Nicole. It is the pre-plucked ombre version human hair lace wig and it, like I said, is the style kinky straight. I'm sorry, I'm gonna try and read all the information so I don't get it wrong. So the wig retails for $249.99, but in South African rands, that is at this very moment R3,367.42. The length that I decided to get was the 20-inch. And the cap construction is lace front. The cap size is, I believe mine came in medium, which is 22.5 inches. The hair density for the lace front is 150%, and it is pre-plucked. It has baby hairs around the perimeter, and the ombre color is a dark brown, according to the website. So I'm going to just get into a few things, like the admin of the wig and stuff like that. I already told you guys the price, the 3,300 rand price, which I think is a reasonable amount for a wig that you will see I didn't have to do too much to put on and to get it looking like laid and all these things. So for me, I think that's reasonable, especially because it's virgin human hair. That is also because I'm used to buying weaves, so I can't really compare to the wigs because I don't really, this is the first wig I've ever gotten as a wig. So if I'm comparing it to other 20 inch bundles of hair and a frontal, that is more or less the same amount. So then obviously there is the charge of the wig being made and this wig is colored as well. And kinky straight, I know, is usually a bit higher priced than other hair types. So for me, that's reasonable. The other thing was shipping. So it took them about a week to get it shipped to me. So with me, I ship everything home. So I ship everything to Cape Town and then I get it sent up to me. So the shipping took a week for it to go from China, I believe it was coming from, to my parents' house, literally just a week. So that was quite quick. And the best part is that I did not pay customs for this. I mean, sometimes even if you're getting sent hair or getting sent things, because of like the shipping method, you still can get charged for customs. But for this one, I wasn't charged for customs. So I think on their side, they also chose like the correct courier and things like that to make sure that I just get the hair delivered to my door and don't have to worry about customs, because that's a big part of having anything being shipped internationally. Okay, so with the actual packaging, it came in a bubble wrapped box, which I really appreciated because this box traveled really far. Like I said, it came from China. So I really appreciate the fact that they were trying to protect the packaging. And by the time it got to me, obviously it was a little bit roughed up, but not too bad. You can still see that the packaging is really, really great. I love the black box. You guys know I love black anything. And then just tied up with a beautiful ribbon. Yes, matching my nails. I did not plan that at all. But then in the box, you get the hair, which is in a net. So the wig is in a net, which is good to protect it. And it's just got like some papers in there to also make sure that it stays well protected, I believe, because of the lace. Also in the box, I received 4 in total wig caps for me to wear underneath the wig. So 2 of the black and then 2 of the nude color, so that I can wear that underneath the wig, which is the one that I chose to wear the nude, so that my scalp, you know, looks lighter rather than darker. And then for free, or rather as a gift, I received the elastic band and the extra clips for the wig, which for me, I didn't really need. They weren't really necessary, but I like the gesture. Just in case I want to tighten the wig later on, I can always just sew those on and use those. So looking at the hair itself, I just put it on to sort of grasp how big the actual cap, the wig cap and the frontal is compared to like my hair, what do I need to cut off and all these things. I have never actually worn a frontal before. I've only worn a 360 frontal, so this is my first time working with an ear to ear frontal. That's why I sort of measured it out, so that I was trying to get everything right the first try. So I realized that it is a little bit too big, and I used a white eyeliner just to draw out where I need to cut the lace off and a little bit of the hair on that frontal. And after that, I went on to the sort of customizing part. I chose not to bleach the knots for this wig purely because I have found that lately I want to make a wig and I want to wear it the next day, and if I have to bleach the knots, it means that I have to wash the wig and then dry it and all these things. So I just want to like find a way to get rid of all that admin. So I didn't bleach these knots. I'll show you guys how I sort of make it look a bit more natural. The only thing that I then did was pluck the frontal, but with that as well, I really didn't do a lot. I don't want baby hairs. I wanted it to look natural, and I wanted to lay the wig, but I also wanted to look like the hair was sort of coming out of my scalp. So I realized with that, if I leave too much lace open, it will actually just look like a balded lace rather than this hair growing out of this lace that looks like it's from your scalp and things like that. So I'm showing you guys like how much I plucked. Not a lot. Nothing crazy. I didn't even pluck like the top part of the wig. I literally just plucked the sides. And then yeah, and then I went on to cut the lace. I cut right where I had drawn that line with the white eyeliner. And yeah, that is basically the customizing it part on the mannequin. So I already had my wig cap on. Like I said, I was using the nude one. I sort of laid my baby hairs. My hair hasn't been relaxed in a while, so my baby hairs aren't like the smoothest, my own natural ones. But I just laid those down so that they could at least look neat and out. Then, because this cap was a little too light, I used my L'Oreal Infallible foundation in the color 320 Caramel Toffee. This is the foundation that I'm actually wearing today, so I felt that it would match best. So after I put on the foundation on the actual cap, I put on the wig. And I'm not sure if I actually mentioned this, but the wig does have adjustable straps in it already, and for me, I felt like that was enough and that would make the wig tight enough for it to sit the way I wanted it to. And so I used that. I put the wig on and I tightened the straps at the back of the wig. And then for the actual laying of the wig, I just used my L'Oreal Paris Extreme Hold indestructible gel glue, which for me, I believe I've said this before on my channel, is the equivalent of the Gotta Be glue gel that most American YouTubers speak about. It really does work wonders. So because I wanted this to look very natural, what I did was I pulled back held up the lace frontal, and then I applied the wig glue around the perimeter of my hair. And I feel like the visuals are so much more helpful than what I'm trying to explain, but I basically make sure that I put it in front of the hair rather than on any of my baby hairs, because I don't want to pull out my hair or anything like that. So I put it like right in front of that hair or right against it. Then I use a comb just to sort of lay down the lace without me having to touch it with my hands. If you have long nails, you can also use your long nails to just sort of press the lace onto the glue. And I do that like all around, and I do it in sections because I want to be very careful with the way I place the lace. And this really does help make it look a lot more natural. It makes the lace look a lot more natural rather than placing the lace and then gluing down your edges or the baby hairs of the wig, if that makes sense. And then yeah, I did that all around, and the wig was basically installed. Then I, you guys know, I live with a middle part always. So I wanted to do a middle part with this hair as well, even though it's quite thick, and I really like that because I wanted to kick it straight. So I wanted a thick, not really afro-y, but on the way to an afro feel or natural hair feel and all that good stuff. So I wanted a middle part and I just started to open a middle part, like basic. And then I went in with my NYX HD concealer in the color CW06, which is the color Glow. And this is quite a light concealer, but I love using it to part, like to make the part stand out for my wigs, because the contrast, especially when I'm using, like when I'm wearing a darker wig, the contrast makes it look a lot more natural. So I just put that all over the middle part. I did use my Kala brow liner, the number 504 brush, to do this. And I also went in a little bit in between the baby hairs to try and make those also look like there's like quite a bit of scalp underneath them, and any other hairs that I felt around the perimeter of the wig needed to just look like there's a contrast between the actual baby hairs and the scalp. I just applied that concealer on there. And then to flatten out, or rather lay out, the hair in the middle part, because it is quite dense, or rather was quite dense, I just used my Baby Bliss Paris hair curler and I put it on the highest setting and I just like pressed the hair down that way. Also, what I like to do just in general is use that curler to press down on the concealer that I just applied, just so it sort of melts into the lace and looks a bit more natural again. And then yeah, that is how I styled the wig and how I worked with the wig right after I got it. I did not open or get the wig out of the hairnet that it came in before I did this video, like on another day, because I really wanted to see if I can take a wig that I'm getting for the first time and make it look the way I want it to look with doing the most minimal of work to it. And I think this wig responded really, really well to that. So a few other things that I'd like to touch on, especially because this is a review, is does the hair shed? So far I haven't experienced any shedding. It's so soft that I don't think it could shed very easily. I found that a lot of times hair starts to shed, like if it the texture's a little bit off and all those things, which indicates that maybe the hair is not genuine. But this one, very genuine, very soft, and no shedding. Like I've been running my hands through it. I could do this all video long, no hairs, you know. The other thing is tangling. I can't say I expected the hair to tangle, but because it's kinky straight, I was a little bit concerned as to like how kinky does the hair get. And if it's kinky, we all know like it's very easy for kinky hair to just get tangled or not, because that's naturally how it behaves. And with this one, I'm very surprised, no tangles at all. And obviously if hair tangles, that usually is the reason why it sheds. So this one's not tangling at all. Granted, I have only been wearing this hair now for an hour, nothing crazy, but so far I'm really experiencing good quality hair, which other hairs from the jump you get a little, you know. Yeah. And then also, I'm sure the big thing that you guys are wondering is color, because I have never really worn brown hair at all. I'm not an in-between person. I either wear like black, like super black, or I wear blonde, like really, really light hair. So this is sort of an in-between for me, and I really, really love this color. I know in some of my snaps, it does tend to look a bit more on the... I think it's going towards like an orange, but it's not like that at all. It's such a beautiful brown that I didn't even know if I'd be able to rock it or put it off, but now I'm just like, I might go for this brown more often. Another point is that the hair is true to length, so it's 20 inches. I do believe that it's quite true to length. Yeah, there's not much else to discuss there. I really am impressed with the hair from afsisterwig.com. I also am very impressed with the service. I really, really had a smooth working with them and all these things. So that's been pretty great. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and you found it quite informative. I'm going to leave the link for fsisterwig.com down below. I'm also going to leave the exact link to this hair for you guys to find and all that good stuff. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to give it a like and comment down below what else you'd like to see me do. I've been thinking of doing like a how I customize my wigs video, so comment down below if you want to see that. And yeah, don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you'd like to see more videos by me. Turn on the post notifications so you know exactly when I post new videos. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. Adds more coverage to those cheeks of mine. This has been a struggle I've been having almost every other day, so bear with me. Just gonna apply it underneath the eyes, down my nose, because I don't contour my nose, I just highlight it, so it sort of gives a contour effect.